So the cost is gonna be around 21 billion, which is slightly less expensive than Curiosity's, which is 2.5 billion. And the reason is because there's an availability of spare parts, which makes the new rover somewhat more affordable. And then NASA reported using the, I think it's pronounced zombie rocket, to test the lander vision system as a part of the autonomous descent and ascent powered flight test bed. Experimental technologies back in 2016 for the 2020 experiment. So this, oh, so this picture is the power source that was left behind, I think, on Curiosity and what the new rover will be using, the thing that lasts 14 years. And this was the sky crane that I think it was a, they were testing a flight for the rover, and it was tethered onto the sky crane.
And Mars 2020 also used like proposed scientific instrument to reach some specific goals. And firstly, it has the planetary instrument for X-ray lithochemistry. But if you look at this, it's X-ray fluorescing, X-ray fluorescing spectrometer to determine the elemental composition of Mars, of Martians' surface materials. And it also has the radar imager for Mars subsurface experiment. It's a ground-penetrating radar that can image the dozens of meters beneath the rover, and it has the Mars oxygen SRU experiment. It's an exploration technology investigation that can produce oxygen from carbon dioxide from Martian atmosphere, and it looks like this. It has the Mars Environmental Dynamic Analyzer. It's a set of the sensors that that can provide measurements of the Mars temperature, the wind speed and direction, and the humidity and the dust slide and shear. Mars 2020 also has the Mars Telescope. It's a solar-powered helicopter, and it has a downward-looking camera at bottom, and it has an inner communication system that can provide data to the rover.